Hi there. It's good to have you today. While reading a paragraph in a book, you might have seen a lot of symbols, signs, and marks like these. These are called punctuation marks. These are full stop, comma, exclamation mark, etc., etc. I've got a story about these marks today. Are you excited to hear about them? I am. Come on, let's read that story. The name of the story is Punctuate My House by Zena Brooke. Hi there, I'm Jordan. I would like to give you a tour of my house. Let's go inside. This is our living room, and over there, sitting in front of the TV, is full stop. But we like to call him a period. Let's go talk to him. Look at how cute the full stop looks, and he's looking at you. Full stop is talking to us. Mr. Period is talking to us. Hi, I like to stop sentences so people can breathe after reading something. For example, I went to the store to get milk, but there was no milk, so I had to wait for them to restock, so I went to go to pay. Oof, this sentence is very long, and you never get to take a break to breathe. Here is the same sentence with full stops. I went to the store to get milk, but there was no milk. I had to wait for them to restock. So I went to play. See, that's so much better. There's one rule you have to follow always. End a sentence with a full stop. Always end a sentence with a full stop. Well, I have to go to get some milk. Nice meeting you, full stop, Jordan says. Now when I read, I make it a point that whenever I see a full stop, I count 1, 2. For example, I went to the store to get milk, but there was no milk. I had to wait for them to restock. So I went to go to play. That's how we make use of a full stop to take some time to breathe. Let's see, who else do we meet in Jordan's house? Here is our kitchen. We love to make pancakes here. Speaking about pancakes, there is exclamation mark making pancakes. Let's go talk to him next. Do you see an exclamation mark in that kitchen? It's a straight line and a dot. Hello. I heard you were learning about punctuations. That's cool. Can I teach you about what exclamation marks are? Oh, exclamation marks make words scream in excitement or pop. For instance, I love pancakes, or I love pancakes. See the difference? Do you smell something burning? Oh no, my pancakes! I got to go! So you use the exclamation mark when there is some excitement, when you have to shout, when you have to scream, or something is disgusting, when there are a lot of emotions to be conveyed, this exclamation mark comes in handy. Let's go ahead and see whom else do we meet. Let's go to the backyard. We have lots of fun things out there. Oh, look, there is question mark playing on the swings. Let's go talk to him. Do you like learning? If don't you, that's okay. But I will teach you about question marks anyways. You use me when you are asking something like when, who, where, what, why, which, and how. Oh, I'll give you an example. Do you have chocolates? Can I have some? It's pretty easy to use. There is not many rules. Just put them at the end of the question. That's it. But when you read a question, there is a slight change in your tone. Do you have chocolates? We don't say, do you have chocolates? Can I have some? But we say, do you have chocolates? Can I have some? It was good meeting question mark, isn't it? Lunch is ready, said Koma. Coming, said Jordan. Let's go get some lunch. Oh, Miss Koma is so pretty over there. Hi, I'm Koma. Fullstop said you were learning about punctuation. Well, you use commas to separate ideas, especially when they are joined by any one of these 7 conjunctions. When you use any one of these 7 conjunctions, we use a comma. What are these conjunctions? They are and, but, for, or, nor, so, and yet. Example, the game was over, but the crowd refused to leave. Like how we stopped for 2 seconds, how we stopped for 2 counts when we saw a full stop. When we see Koma auntie, we stop for 1 second. That is, the game was over, but the crowd refused to leave. Interesting, isn't it? Let's see if we meet somebody else. Hi, Jordan. Jordan's friend was quotation mark. Nice to meet you. Can we tell you the importance of quotation mark? 2 are used to show that someone is talking. Now, when you start the sentence with a quotation mark and end the sentence with a quotation mark, this means that this sentence is said by somebody else. For example, we need to go to the store, said Emily. Emily told, we need to go to the store. I think this is a good idea, replied Jordan. So they went to the store together. We don't know who is talking or if someone is talking or not, or it is the narrator who is telling if we don't use the quotation mark. We'll never come to know if somebody is talking or not talking if we don't use the quotation mark. Beautiful quotation marks up and down, right? Well, I think it's time for you to go home. It is getting late. I hope you have learned a lot about punctuation today. I'll see you again soon. Interesting story, isn't it? I hope you've learned a little about punctuation mark. Next time you see a full stop, count 2. And you see a comma, count. And when you see a question mark, don't forget to change your tone. Until next time, bye-bye.